Hey, everybody. Can y'all hear me? Can you see me? Well, it's just Teresa. Look what we got. We got our GoPro hooked up. We've got our dog. Got my camera. Got some more stuff in. So I can draw live now. I don't have to do everything on the iPad. I can actually draw regular pictures. So this is a beautiful little guy. I don't know if it's a guy or a girl. I think it's a girl order that I've had sitting on the table for about a month that I need to get done. So here we go. Let me, I know I got the picture up there where you guys can see it, but I need to open a nice big one on the screen for me as well. Yeah, that's a cute one too. But I'll keep the... So I got the desktop going on. I got 50,000 things going on here. I got this opened. I got Streamlabs going. I got wires going all around me. And I got pictures opened up. I probably should have set up a second monitor, but I will. So let's get these guys. So I'll just kind of look here at my phone. If you guys chat with me, I've got my phone laying here so I can see your chats too. So I've been fighting. That's why you guys haven't heard from me in a little while. So for all this, first of all, I've been waiting on to get this other device in so I can mount this GoPro. And the other thing is Streamlabs has been giving me a fit of it won't let me stream to Facebook and YouTube at the same time. And since I've been getting the most views and things from Facebook, I'm going to stick with Facebook for a little while. And what I'll probably do is hopefully I'll be able to upload this video to YouTube later. We'll see. Because I imagine it's just like all the rest of them. But anyway, this little sweet little baby here needs to be drawn. And it's been sitting in my thing here for a while. All right, let me zoom in so I can see what I'm doing. I always start with the features when I draw, especially Yorkies. I'll start with the nose. Get that nose. I start with the nose first. Get that inked in. I'll do a little bit of quick stippling for my shading on the nose. Hey everybody, I see we got quite a few people watching. We got Diane is watching in Brooklyn, Melissa, Chris, my cousin, Teresa Singleton. Yeah, I get more watchers on here. I really should work on my Facebook, my YouTube channel, but and I will. Alright, there's I'm gonna come in with a finer line than that. Go a little bit more to find a detail. That is might be it right there. I'm gonna use a little bit of hatching too. So I need my fine line. I have this picture to do, and then next in line, I have a portrait to do for a very nice family from Ohio. You know who you are if you're watching, and no, I have not forgotten about you. I've just been busy trying to make a living during this crazy shutdown stuff. So I've been doing a lot of door dashing. Over here I can use. It's pretty close. Yep, got the pen. Yeah, here's one. Yeah, this one is. So yeah, these are what I call caricatures, but I still treat these kind of pretty much like a portrait. I don't do a lot of crazy goofy detail. I mean, crazy goofy stain stuff with some of these. I do on some. It just depends on the animal. Yorkies are so sweet anyway. They have a lot of personality. And a lot of it's based off of their hair. Pretty good. I hope everybody's ready for Mother's Day. It's tomorrow. Take care of the mamas. In the club, I don't have mine anymore, so I will make sure my wife has a great Mother's Day. I think this is a girl. She's got bow in her hair. So I'm going to go ahead and go Well, I won't even say it's a girl. Alright, so that's looking pretty good. We'll come back down here and do a little more chin, and I'll probably go up to the eyes. So what I'm working from, you guys see this one picture that I've got, but I've got another picture over here, and the dog's a lot more trimmed in the other picture. So it's been my experience that although they are extremely cute when they first come back from the groomers, you, at least in my opinion, you capture more of the personality when their hair grows out just a little bit, and you get a little more of that, what I'd say, the nuances of the dog with their hair, how their hair lays and everything. That's personally where I find a lot of the character. Especially in some of these dogs that maybe, you know, a lot of them look very similar. Good, looking good. Just maybe a little bit of shading on that tongue. I'll do a lot of this with shading with color pencils, obviously, too, but. Try stream to Twitch too, which I will. Still got some more stuff on the ball too. I'm gonna get another camera, so I don't have to use my DSLR. Probably get a nice webcam. Alright, let's work on his eyes. Everybody loves the eyes. Use a little bit of artistic license. I'm going to work off this other photo that does not have hair hanging down in front of the eye. This dog has some unusual looking eyes for a Yorkie. See this picture, I think this dog has a little bit of age on it too. Especially I'm seeing around the eyes. just want to remind you guys, I do have a live chat here right here on my phone. So if you guys talk to me, I can respond if you have any questions or anything. Or you can just watch. I'm not picky. Just happy to have a few of y'all watching right now. Too much. So this outer line, one of my little tricks that I do, I guess the reason you call the call these caricatures is this outer line I was always trying to make it a little thicker. Define the shape. Hey, Dean Borden's watching. I haven't seen that name in a while. Krishna. Jan Milam.
Okay.
Now he's starting to take a little bit of shape. At least the head is. Y'all see what I mean? Defining the shape. Still trying to keep it accurate so that it looks like this dog. Hopefully when I'm done, it'll be unique. Happy to see this dog have a nice loose collar on it. Can't stand to see a dog with a collar too tight. It chokes him. You can't have him too loose either. Okay. Well, that is too cute. So I just noticed that the tag this dog has on it, this little, is the exact same one we just bought for Alice. It's the little Princess Tiara. This is definitely a little girl. Looking good, looking good, I think. characteristics. That hair. A lot of fun. That's why I enjoy dogs. They're obvious reasons that everybody, a lot of people love dogs, but artistically I love trying to capture all the fun and whimsy and the nuances that make them unique. Another thing that I try to do is I try not to get too bogged down in detail in these. You'll see I'll work for a little area for a little bit and then I'll move on and I'll come back to it if I need to. That's always helped me keep from overworking something when I'm working on it, as I bounce around a lot. Okay. So I'm going to leave that alone and then we'll move back up here to the neck area again. Start working on these little gray. Well, they're not gray yet. They will be when I cut and color, but area coming out front of the neck. Contrast between the that tannish brown on the face area and head, and then he's gonna have that, or she's gonna have that gray darker area where the body meets that. Foot here. So I guess another reason I could say this is a caricature is as I'm drawing this, so every time I move to a new section, especially with this fur, so what I do is I look and see which shapes jump out at me first. Like immediately I saw that little shape right there on the top. So I guess in that aspect, I treat it very much like a caricature, is what jumps out to me. And that's kind of where I select what I focus on detail-wise too. as I was saying, I move around a lot, but because I guess as the viewer, someone who looks at their animal every day, you know, that's what are the things that you're going to see? What are those little nuances that jump out? Do I have anybody on here right now? I think a few of y'all popped in and popped out. That's okay. I'm sure people will go back and watch it later too. I think that's what happens a lot with live videos. People pop in for a few minutes, and I mean, it's not the most exciting thing to sit here and watch me draw, but I get it. Later on, you can hit fast forward and get to the good parts. So I know that's what I do a lot. Well, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this for today. I appreciate all of y'all and of course, I'll go back and I'll finish the rest of the dog, and I may do another live stream when I start adding color, if y'all are interested. That'll probably be sometime next week. Anyway, this is what we did today so far. Of course, I gotta go and erase off a pencil. I'm going to do that now, actually. Clean up all these pencil lines from my sketch. Yeah, I did skip that part with y'all for this one. I had this sketch now, so nothing real exciting about the sketching process, at least for this one. This one was pretty much portrait-y style, so I it was a tedious process whenever I do them, but I don't have a lot of exaggeration. I generally like to do more gut feeling, but I didn't on this one because I don't know. I think this lady's looking for more of a portrait. So, anyway, there's that. Thank y'all for watching. Thank you for tuning in today. I hope y'all enjoyed this first time. First time I've done it this way, because there again, like I said at onset, I was having some issues. I wanted to be able to stream to here and to YouTube at the same time, but for some reason it did okay the first time, and then this time it would not pull my Facebook, so I logged completely out of my software and logged in strictly with Facebook today. Anyway, y'all have a wonderful weekend. Have a wonderful Mother's Day to all the mothers, and if you have your mother, give her a big hug for me. You guys have a great weekend. Thanks.